السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا على نعمة الإسلام، فهذه النعمة العظيمة التي أنقذنا الله بها من الظلمات إلى النور، ومن علينا بها بخير خلقه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وقدوتنا وأسوتنا ومعلمنا وسراجنا المنير محمد رسول الله، صلوات ربي وسلامه عليك سيدي وحبيبي وشفيعي يا رسول الله. ثم ما بعد، after praising Allah and sending salam and salutations to the noble Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. He is one and he has no partners. And I also testify that the noble messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the final prophet and slave of Allah the Almighty. I'm very fortunate and it gives me a great pleasure to be in this very auspicious gathering, very auspicious conference, which is talking about the greatest human being, Prophet Muhammad salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi. I would like to extend my gratitude to the Iqra Bangla and Urdu Iqra TV and its team, and especially I would like to extend my gratitude to respected and honorable Imam Sheikh Mufti Abdul Muntaqim Hafizahullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you all the goodness for giving me this opportunity to speak in front of the audience. Respected elders and my dear brothers and sisters, we are talking about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam tonight in this very special month, historical month, month of Rabi'in al-Awwal, a month which has been considered as the most historical month in the Arabic calendar. I'd like to share with you some of the beautiful sayings of some of the great scholars and poets and thinkers of Islam. So here we have Ahmed Shawqi, a great Egyptian poet. He says in one of his poetries, he says, وُلِدَ الْهُدَى فَالْكَائِنَاتُ ضِيَاءُ وَفَمُ الزَّمَانِ تَبَسُّمٌ وَثَنَاءُ. He says, وُلِدَ الْهُدَى, the guidance was born, the guidance arrived. فَالْكَائِنَاتُ ضِيَاءُ, the whole entire universe has been enlightened. وَفَمُ الزَّمَانِ, the face of the time, تَبَسُّمٌ, smiling and praising because of the arrival of Prophet Muhammad salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi. This is Ahmed Shawqi, a famous Egyptian poet. Then you have people like Imam al-Busayri rahimahullah, a great scholar and a great spiritual figure and mentor in the history of Islam. He says in his beautiful poem Al-Burda, so he says, Muhammadun Sayyidul Kawnaini, Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, master of the both worlds, dunya and akhirah, this world and the next world. Sayyidul Kawnaini wa Thaqalain, and he is the master of the both worlds. Sayyidul Kawnaini wa Thaqalain wal Fariqaini min Urbin wa min Ajami, and he is the master, he is the Sayyid of the Arab, the people of from the Arabian Peninsula, the Arab, and also the Ajam, those who are considered as non-Arabs. وَالْفَرِيقَيْنِ مِنْ عُرْبٍ وَمِنْ عَجَمِ. Then he says, مُحَمَّدٌ أَشْرَفُ الْأَعْرَابِ وَالْعَجَمِ. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best of the Arabs and non-Arabs. مُحَمَّدٌ خَيْرُ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَىٰ قِدَمِ. And Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best human being that ever walked on this earth, on this planet. Then you find Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu, the personal poet, شاعر خاص بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says, وَأَحْسَنُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَقَطُ عَيْنِي. That وَأَحْسَنُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَرَقَطُ عَيْنِي. No eyes have ever witnessed anybody better than you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَأَجْمَلُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. No beautiful child has ever been arrived, or no mother has ever gave birth to any child as beautiful as you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَجْمَلُ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. Then he says, خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ. You have been created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free from all kind of errors and faults and mistakes and even any kind of aib of creation as figure and shape the way he looked. خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء. As if though you have been wanted to come and you have been wanted to be created the way you have been created. This is Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu, sha'ir, the poet of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we speak about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are speaking about one of those individuals which has been considered, or who has been considered as the most influential and inspirational and most successful man in the history of mankind. Of course, we as Muslims, we believe in it, we witness, and we of course wholeheartedly believe in it. But the greatness of an individual is understood when the tribute, when the respect, when the honor coming from outside the fold of the religion, when tribute coming from the non-Muslim intelligence, intellectuals, non-Muslim scholars and politicians. You talk about Michael Haychat, we repeatedly mentioned. He wrote a book called The Hundred, and he was interested to speak about 100 most influential men in the history of mankind. And he had, not just being a Christian writer of Heart Foundation in United States of America, being a Christian writer, he had no choice but to place Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to be on the top of the list in his book, The Hundred. People like Alphonse de Lamartine, a French intelligent politician, writer, he considers Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam as the most successful man on spiritual and on secular, in the level of dunya and in the level of akhirah, on spiritual and even on the worldly level, he considers him to be most influential man and successful man, Alphonse de Lamartine, a French writer, intelligent and politician. Mahatma Gandhi, an Indian philosopher, thinker, and an Indian politician, he also finds Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to be the most dedicated, most devoted, most sacrificing individual for his people and for the benefit of mankind. Thomas Carlyle and many others, British Encyclopedia, the Britannica, considers him to be the most influential and most successful man. Despite the fact that he was the youngest prophet, he came 500 years after Christianity, after Prophet Isa alayhi wa ala nabiyyina salam. Yet, he is one of the most influential men in the history of mankind. He is, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most remembered name. You talk about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go and check each and every single Muslim country, check the Muslims wherever they're living. Adhan has been given every single day, and in every adhan, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has been pronounced in a loud voice on the microphones. Ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah. In every iqama, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has been pronounced and mentioned. In every tashahud, we are saying assalamu alayka ayyuhan nabiyyu. In every tashahud, in sitting, last sitting of salah, we are sending salah and salam to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We are sending durood to our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Most remembered name on this planet. Every single moment of the time, there are people who are talking about him, remembering him, sending salah and salam to him, sending durood upon him. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the name itself, the most common name, is the most keeping name. Check Muslim world, you find Muhammad is a family name. Almost every names for the people who come from the Bay of Bengal, Pakistan, India, Asian subcontinent, and much part of the non-Arab world, you find every name begins with Muhammad for the love and barakah and for the compassion and love for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, including the United Kingdom. We have seen recently in one of the reports which showed that Muhammad is the most common name in the United Kingdom, despite the fact that we're living as a minority here. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his rawdah, his tomb, his grave is one of the busiest graves that you can ever find on this earth. Since day one, it has never been empty. Crowd can be seen, witnessed in Ramadan, outside Ramadan. And of course, I don't have to say anything about the Hajj. Shows the love and respect and honor for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was indeed an icon, a sign in Tawheed, in oneness of Allah, in monotheism. You know, people before Islam, they were engaged in worshipping idols, statues, objects, things other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came and he rescued the humanity from polytheism, from the crime of shirk, to the light of a tawheed, light of oneness of Allah, the monotheism, which has been the teaching of each and every single prophet, alayhimus salam. Every prophet, starting from Adam all the way through Ibrahim, Noah, Moses, Musa, Isa, Jesus, peace be upon all of them, they all preached innama ilahukum ilahum wahid. Every one of them preached the oneness of Allah. Allah is one and only, an icon in monotheism. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was an example. He was the universal role model on the spiritual level, as I have mentioned earlier. Alphonse de Lamartine, he says, and he spoke about it, he was an icon on the level of obedience, at-ta'abbud, and spirituality. And Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, she says that he was kana yata'abbad, he would pray qiyamul layl, he would pray during the night until his fits would get swollen. Hatta tawarramat qadamahu. He was an example, an ayah, a sign in worshipping Allah the Almighty. He was a sign, an icon in dealing and transaction. He is the one, this has been derived from his teaching, ad-dinul mu'amala, that religion itself is transaction, it's dealing, it's how we are with your people. He was an icon on dealing and transaction, and in public relation, how you should be with people. And he said, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتْ فَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ تَمْحُوهَا وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. He asked us to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he concludes by saying to be good with people, good, وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was an icon, he was a sign, a symbol of equality amongst the human beings. As you know, human beings suffer from racial problems. Nationalism to certain degrees can be okay, but if it leads to the racism and problems of superiority, then it becomes a problem. But Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught the humanity, he treated the problems, the disease of at-ta'assub, al-asabiyya, al-jahiliyya. He is the one who said very clearly in the final pilgrimage, the last speech, the khutbat hijjat al-wida, he says, ala inna rabbakum wahid, be aware that your Lord is one, be aware that your Father is one. And then he says, antum min adam, antum banu adam, you are the children of Adam, wa adamu min turab, and Adam alayhi salam, he was from dust, meaning you as all part of Adamic family, you all go back to one Father, and that's Adam alayhi salam. In akramakum inda Allahi atqakum, the best one of you is the one who is best in the sight of Allah, not the one who belongs to a specific family, or belongs to a clan, or belongs to a tribe, or belongs to a nationality or ethnicity, or maybe someone who has some good, a different color, white, black, brown, or maybe some sort of size. No, none of those. All have been treated and destroyed by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They're all okay as for identity, to recognize one another, but as a superiority, if you are best in the sight of Allah and best in the sight of Prophet Muhammad, best with people, fellow human beings, then you are best in the sight of Allah. He was an icon, a symbol in giving the rights of women. Today, people speak about women's rights, but honestly, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he spoke 1441 years ago. He's the one who said, "Inna man nisa'u shaqa'iqu ar-rijal." The women are equivalent as men. Of course, the roles and responsibilities are slightly different as Allah distributed, but in terms of respect and honor and recipients receiving the rewards, they are absolutely same. Inna man nisa shaqa'iqu ar-rijal. Who speaks and who complains about human rights in Islam? Islam is all about human rights. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gave the rights of the minority living in a Muslim majority country. He is the one who clearly said, he was an icon in giving the rights of minority. He says, man qatala dhimmiyan, whoever kills somebody a non-Muslim living in a Muslim majority country, لم يرح رائحة الجنة. He would never even be able to smell Jannah, let alone entering and getting near to Jannah. Check this, rights of minority living in a Muslim majority country. من قتل ذميا أهل الذمة رجلا من أهل الذمة لم يرح رائحة الجنة. He was an icon in mercy, compassion, love. And he is the one who said, Ar-Rahimuna Yarhamuhum Ar-Rahman. The kind ones, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala become kind with them. And those who be kind to the one on earth and the one in heaven will be kind to you. He was an icon, a symbol in character. Akhlaq, Quran says very clearly, Wa innaka la'ala khuluqin azim. You have been based upon the best character. And so we can go on and on. But this is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is indeed the best of human beings. He is indeed most honorable, most respected, most dignified, influential, inspirational, successful, most remembered, most keeping name that we have ever witnessed in the history of mankind. Today, at this time of the difficulties that we are suffering, all sorts of problems in the Muslim world and even outside the Muslim world, we are all as part of Adamic family, be Muslims or non-Muslims, we have something to learn from this great individual, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's get back to his seerah, his teachings and his ways, his understanding, his fashion, his style, his sunnah, his ways, then inshallah we can expect rewards and success in this world and in the next world. With this word, I would like to conclude. I'm very much grateful to Iqra TV and especially Mufti Muhammad Abdul Muntaqim Hafizahullah for giving me this opportunity. Wa hayyakum Allah wa shakara Allahu lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.